Hello and welcome to another tutorial from Ilan Creative Co. I'm Christina and in this tutorial I want to show you how to create a half drop repeat pattern in Adobe Illustrator. Before we get started, let's talk about full drop versus half drop repeat patterns. As an example, I have these two polka dot patterns. On the left side, we have a full drop repeating pattern. This is the way patterns are usually repeated. So the polka dots are perfectly aligned on the vertical lines and on the horizontal lines. Here on the left side, I have a half drop repeating pattern. As you can see, the polka dots are perfectly aligned on the vertical line, but once you go to the horizontal line, they drop halfway down, and then the same distance is kept between the pattern motifs. Half drop repeat patterns are perfect for more complex artwork in which you want to hide the way the motifs are repeated. Open Illustrator and create a new document. I usually set the size of my artboard at 6 by 6 inches. You can use any size you want, just make sure it's a square and write it down. Then go to Advanced Options and set the color mode you want to use. I usually use CMYK and set the resolution to high or 300 pixels per inch. Let's give it another name. And then click Create to open your file. For today's pattern, I want to use these flowers that I drew using Procreate and then I vectorized in Illustrator. I'm going to select everything and then click Ctrl or Command C to copy them. And then I'm going to go back to my pattern file and go to Edit and Paste to add them to the artboard. I want to make a very simple half drop repeat pattern for this tutorial, so I'm going to start with the edges of the artboard and then I'm going to fill the middle. So first, let's zoom out. Select your items and make sure they are grouped by pressing Ctrl or Command G. And then move everything to the upper left corner of the artboard. If you've made seamless repeating patterns before, you know that everything that's outside the artboard at the top needs to be repeated inside the artboard at the bottom. So for that, we are going to go to Object, Transform, Move. The shortcut for this is Shift, Control, or Command if you're using a Mac, and M. So click on Move. And if you remember, I told you to write down the size of your artboard. So my artboard is 6 inches. So right now, I just want to move this to the bottom of the artboard. So I'm going to enter 0 on the horizontal and I am going to enter 6 on the vertical and then click preview to see what happens. So as you can see, this was moved at the bottom of the artboard. So click copy because we want to move a copy of our flowers. This is the way our pattern will be repeated on the vertical line. The next step is to make sure that everything that's outside the artboard on the left side will be repeated inside the artboard on the right side. Let's select these two flowers. Press Ctrl+Shift+M to open the Move tool. And now we want to move them 6 inches on the horizontal side, and we do not want to move them on the vertical. Check and uncheck preview to see what happens, and then click copy to save it. We have the corners of the artboard filled, and now we have to add the flowers to the middle. So I'm going to take this flower that's on the upper left side, selected, and I want to move that to the middle of the canvas. And as you remember, I told you at the beginning of this video that we will have to move it halfway down. So press Ctrl+Shift+M again to open the Move tool, and I want to take it halfway to the horizontal, that means 3 inches, and then halfway down. So again, 3 inches on the vertical. And click preview to see what happens and then copy to save it. My pattern motif might be just a bit too large, but I don't want to have too many gaps between the flowers. So I'm going to leave it like that, but you can also make some of your motifs a bit smaller to have just a bit more movement in your pattern. The pattern I have in the middle goes outside the artboard at the bottom. So I want to create another copy here at the top. So what I'm going to do is select these flowers, open the move tool again, and I don't want to move it on the horizontal, and I want to move it to the top of the artboard on the vertical. So to move it up, you have to enter minus and then the size of your artboard, which is 6 in my case. Let's click on preview to see what happens, and then click copy to save it. If you want a fuller pattern, now is the time to add other elements to your pattern, like dots or leaves or small flowers to fill in the gaps between your motifs. I'm going to leave it as it is, and I'm going to select everything and then press Ctrl G to group all the items. The next step is to add a background to the pattern. So for that, I'm going to use the rectangle tool. You can press M on your keyboard to open it. Select the color you want to use. I want to use an off-white. And then click on your artboard and enter the width and height of your artboard. Then click OK to create your rectangle. Then use the align tools to align it perfectly to the artboard. Then I'm going to switch to the selection tool. Right click on the rectangle, go to arrange and send it to the back. Now that we have made a seamless half drop repeating pattern, all we have left to do is to save it. Before we save it, we can select everything and then go to Object, Expand, and click on it. All my elements are vector elements, so the Expand tool doesn't help me, but if you have different opacities or if you have used different brushes, you will need to do that before you can save it or crop it. Another thing to remember is that if you use raster images, you will have to embed them before you can save the pattern. If you want, you can crop everything that's outside the artboard, but today I want to use the pattern tool. So select everything and go to Object, Pattern, Make. A copy of this pattern was added to the swatches panel, but my pattern is not seamless yet. So what I have to do is make sure that size style to art is not selected and then enter the width and the height of my artboard. And now I have a perfectly repeating pattern. To save it, just click on done. And let's test it. I'm going to use the rectangle tool again, select the pattern from the swatches panel, and create a large rectangle. Let's also resize it by going to Object, Transform, Scale, and I just want to transform the pattern, so I'm going to uncheck Transform Objects, and let's scale it to 70%. Click OK to save. This is our seamless half drop repeating pattern. Hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more pattern design tutorials. Thanks for watching!